So today we're going to take a look at the Traveller's Notebook. That's a full-size one, and the passport size notebook. I've used them both for a while. I'm going to let you know what I think of them, and you can decide whether they might be the kind of thing you'd like. Now, I'm also going to be giving away this passport size traveler's notebook, a couple of unused inserts and some spare elastics. So listen out for what you have to do to get it. Okay, so what we've got here are two traveler's notebooks. So yeah, this is the full-size one, and this is what they call the passport size one. I saw one of these on the Stuff and Things channel, which has had lots of views, and I thought, oh, that looks really nice. Rushed out and bought one. Well, I didn't rush out, I bought one. And I used it for a good while, but I stopped using it. And I'm going to tell you what the pluses and minuses are with these things. So what you do is you basically buy in the cover, and then you buy the inserts. And these are like, unlike the rotafarden. So if you use a rotafarden one, say if you buy a B5 one, an A5 one rather, you can use basically any A5 book in it. And fair play to rotafarden for making them that way. Traveler's notebooks, you can't really do that because this is a slim size. You can buy refills that aren't Traveler's notebook ones from the Traveler's company, but the paper is good quality, and it takes pens and pencils nicely. And it actually, this, I tried this in my typewriter, and it takes typewriter hammer blows really well. And what you do, you buy these refills. I've got loads of them here that I used, as you can see. Like my Luke term 1917, I took the covers off because what you use these elastic bands. So if you want more than one insert in your traveler's notebook, you put the covers together like that, you get one of these elastic bands, and you kind of fix it together like this, you see. I hope that's not too noisy. So then you've got like more than one insert. So you could have a blind one, you could have a plain one, you could have a squared one, whatever. But that means if you've got like, you know, you can see there I've got like six craft. I like the craft cardboard covers, but I don't need them in the notebook. You know, I don't need them in this cover as well, and it just felt a bit stupid and they were getting in the way. So let me just take that off. So what I did, I took the covers off, and I had them like this, and it made the whole thing slimmer and lighter. Although I will say I did notice that taking these off lost some of the rigidity, which isn't an easy word to say, but I think I did it quite well. I used these for a good while and I found them really useful. It was like my, what I was going to do in the day, that kind of thing. My to-dos, so I tried the square one there, as you can see, squared paper. This is a plain one, so I tried that. But ultimately, I found I was having to write really small to fit anything on the page. The clue's in the name, to be honest. It's called a traveler's notebook, so it's like probably designed to be traveled with. If you've not seen these on the internet, take a look. It's like as if the more inserts, the more stuff people have got in these things. And it's nice to look at, I suppose. It's like makes it feel nice and meaty and whatever. But the more stuff you put in, the more it comes out. You know, it doesn't really fit. The more the elastic stretches. But if you stuff a load of, you know, inserts and whatever in there, you're going to stretch the elastic or it's going to break. It doesn't really work very well. It's not very elegant. I personally don't feel it's very Japanese. I found it much better to have at most three inserts. And do you know what? How many inserts can you use at any one time? I mean, on the plus side, this slips really nicely into your jeans back pocket. So if you're carrying a cake and a cup of coffee and you want to carry your notebook as well, you know, you're going to be okay, kids. This is the passport size. Nice little thing. It is nice to keep in your bag. I found this a bit of a faff. Like I was out having lunch with someone one time and wanted to write something down for them, and to get the page out was a real sort of, oh yeah, maybe I'm clumsy, but you know, that's not very nice, is it? It's a nice little thing. I don't know whether there's any value over what I've got here. This is a Luke term 1917. Really like these little pocket notebooks. It's the size is slightly different, slightly bigger, but not much, slightly taller. The thing is, when it's full, it's full. You need a new one. With the traveler's notebooks, when your insert's full, you just get a new one. So it doesn't cost as much. The investment up front is in the cover. I think these are okay if you want something to, they say it's great for making lists. Well, you can make lists in any notebook. If you'd like the slim format, maybe this is for you. I decided it wasn't for me, and I went for instead the Rotafaden Taschenbuch lighter. Now, if you'd like to be the lucky recipient of this passport-sized traveller's notebook, a couple of unused inserts and some spare elastics, I just want you to tell me what your favourite Japanese thing is and why. And I want you to be humorous, okay, ladies and gentlemen? Look out for the Rotafaden booklet reviews coming up soon. I've ordered those. I'm really excited to get them. And if there's any products you'd like me to cover, let me know in the comments. If you've enjoyed this video, why not subscribe and check out one of the others? Look out for posts in the community section and channel memberships coming soon. Bye for now.